Welcome into the Cleveland Browns Report. I'm your host, Matthew Peterson. Week 6 recap coming at you today. My hair is a mess because I've been pulling at it for the last 4 quarters because the Cleveland Browns just got absolutely pile-driven into the ground by the Arizona Cardinals. 37-14, the final. This score does not reflect the game because it shouldn't be 14. There is a Hail Mary at the end of the first half that gives the Browns a little bit of swagger, a little bit of confidence coming into the second half, and it completely melted away. It fell away so quickly, it was kind of like that fat guy in Lilo and Stitch that kept dropping his mint chocolate chip ice cream. That was the Browns' offense today. Shout out to any Disney fans out there. Baker Mayfield, there's a lot to unpack here. One, the guy's tough. I said it before. What does he drink? What's in his water? I don't understand how he can be kicking the ground in pain and somehow not miss a snap. I mean, kudos to you on that department. That is just, no one denies you that. And for how tough you are, you should never really get booed. I can understand wanting to boo players that aren't performing well. But when you're that tough and you continue to drag your banged up shoulder on the field and play through some serious pain, you deserve to get overridden with the boos. Having said that, turnovers. No ball security. I mean, you feel the pass rush. Hold on to the ball. You're drafted first overall, and look who else was drafted first overall. It's not fair to you to get compared to other first overall picks. I get that. But look how Kyler Murray played today. It's apples to oranges, but at the same time, when you're drafted first overall and you're playing at home against an undefeated team, that's why you got picked first overall for these games. When shit's hitting the fan a little bit and you lose last week in a close one on the road and blow a big second-half lead, you need a bounce-back win at home. You have to lead the team. Does it all fall on your shoulders? No, but that's part of the deal of being a quarterback. That's just life in 2021 for quarterbacks. You take the highs, but you have to deal with the lows. It's just so frustrating. I can understand people on both sides of the whole Baker Mayfield contract extension, where you feel about him. They both raised good points, but damn it. I mean, today sucked. All right, that's part of the rant. How about this? Let's lighten the mood. Grade Baker's performance for me down in the comments section. A, B, C, D, or F. I'm not going to give my grade. I'm just going to let the people think, and then I'm going to go down to the comments, and I'm going to start, you know, taking pieces and bits of opinions from other people and putting my thoughts together because there's so much with this quarterback. It's tough to nail down. On one hand, the Browns have not had a quarterback in a very long time. Shout out to Bernie Kosar, the last good one, really, for that consistent period of time. But also, there's no more good losses, okay? And at a certain point, the buck has to stop, and you have to just move on from the losses and be the first overall pick that you were. And that's why this evaluation just is not that simple. I wish it was, but you're talking about a franchise that, frankly, has lost a lot in the last 2 decades. And for the first time ever, they're winning a playoff game. They're going to the playoffs. So you want to ride those highs. But also, you have to look and go, we are not just here to compete a couple Sundays. We're here to win Super Bowls. That's what you do in the NFL. So don't settle, okay? It's like that, was it State Farm commercial, the Settlers back in like 2016? No settling. You got to improve on it. Mayfield's stats against the Cardinals this week, not good, right? I wish we had the 2 fumbles on the screen too, but I don't want to add salt to the wound here. Throws a pair of touchdowns. If there's not that Hail Mary, those numbers are really bad, okay? We're looking at south of 200 yards, 1 touchdown. You take away 1 completion. It's not pretty. So you're 1 Hail Mary away from these numbers being putrid. Instead, at a box score glance, they're passable. But if you watch the game, not really. Also, if you watch the game, you know that the Browns, unfortunately, did not cover +2.5. I think the over did hit, though. Make some money on the Browns, okay? Head on over to BetUS right now. Use the link at the bottom of your screen, chatsports.com/bet. When you plug in the promo code Browns125, they hook you up with a 125% deposit bonus. Browns, Broncos, Week 7, Thursday Night Football in Cleveland. I bet Cleveland favored by 4.5 points. We'll wait for the lines to get out. Maybe make some money right there. The Broncos are looking pretty bad right now at home against the Raiders. So check them out. chatsports.com/bet. Promo code Browns125. On some brighter news, as I try to, you know, keep it together up here, DPJ, this is the guy we've been waiting to see, okay? For the Browns fans that followed him closely in the preseason, in the training camp, he was the talk of the talk, and we saw it. He was running over people. He was climbing up a ladder in the end zone to haul in that Hail Mary. I don't care if it's meaningless or not. That shows something, especially when this receiver room has some question marks revolving around OBJ. What role does he have? What's his future? Jarvis Landry, he's coming back from IR soon, hopefully next week. Is he looking for a new number two? Because it looks like it may be him and DPJ. Look at the stats, though, from weeks 1 through 4 through 5 through 6 for Donovan Peoples-Jones. And they speak for themselves. It's a huge jump. And what he's done the last 2 weeks, would love to see this pattern continue. Because if the Browns can add even more weapons, especially with, I don't know, maybe say the loss of, unfortunately, Kareem Hunt, they could take that right about now. So, come on, please. DPJ, do it for all of us right now. We need a little boost on offense. Baker needs some extra help. You're a six-round pick. This is a good time to turn things around for the offense, which desperately needs it. Speaking of problems, what's the biggest problem the Browns currently have? Should I answer it? I don't know. I'm kind of getting a little ahead of myself here. I'm very fast-paced. I'm really pissed off about this. So go down in the comment section. What do you think it is? I thought the offensive line would be fine today. Love what Cleveland's done in terms of their depth of the offensive line the last couple of years. Wasn't all that concerned with no Wills and Conklin. Didn't have Wills last week. Conklin, that's a tough blow, sure, but the tackles were bad. Mayfield had a lot of pressure. Granted, some of it was on himself for holding onto the ball too long. Or maybe the defense. Maybe the defense that has just completely melted away the last 2 weeks against West Coast teams. Whatever it may be, sound off in the comments section. Let's all cry together. OBJ now. Your turn, buddy, because where do we evaluate your play today? It's difficult. On one hand, you look at the box score, 5 receptions. What does that say? 79 yards, not too shabby. On the other hand, you got to catch that 4th down pass. The Browns, at that point, were not out of the game. They get the 1st down there, put it in the end zone, have some momentum, turn things around. Instead, you dropped it, okay? And you dropped a key 4th down pass last week, too. You got to get it together. Because people are calling for your head to get traded. And I have to imagine, maybe you do, maybe you don't want to get traded, but I bet you don't want to pack up and move, because that sucks. And I did that not too long ago, and you probably don't. So for that reason alone, and for that reason, please, catch 4th down passes. Because you caught some other great passes, and that was fine and dandy, and that was nice to see. I love some of the game planning, the targets you were getting, the strategizing, the scheming to get you more involved. But at the end of the day, you're paid nearly $16 million. You have to catch that ball on 4th down to get the first. That's why it's an up-and-down day for OBJ. That big down is going to sink him a little bit. It's going to make people put, it's like Ricky Bobby. I got a pretzel on my head. I don't know how to evaluate you so far. It's been tough this season. There's things that you're responsible for, and there's things like you're not responsible for, like the Vikings missed throw when you're wide open. Baker can't hit you for an easy touchdown. That's out of your control. But 2 4th down drops, that is your control. So for that reason, get it together. Also, if you haven't subscribed already to the Browns Report, you should get it together too. I'm passionate about this game because I know Browns fans are passionate too. So go ahead and like and subscribe right now. We're almost at 3,000 subscribers. Be the one that gets us over. Subscribe right now to the Cleveland Browns Report. Moving on. Kareem Hunt unfortunately went down late in the fourth quarter midway through the fourth quarter with what looked to be like a serious injury. Got carted off the field, was grabbing his calf, grabbing his knee. Not really sure. Scanning over the Browns beat reporters. No one's got a beat on it just yet. Would probably come out in the Stefanski press conference at what point he'll say he'll get an MRI, we'll know more tomorrow, or he'll just unfortunately say the news I'm dreading, which is he's done for the season. He looked defeated, gave deuces up on the cart leaving the field. Not a good sight, especially when you factor in Nick Chubb missed today with a calf injury, and Hunt makes Chubb so much better because when both of them are in the game plan, defenses cannot prepare as well for what to expect on offense. When it's just Chubb, you know you're not going to see a lot of pass plays out in the flat to the running back. They save Hunt for that. It's a tough blow if Hunt is gone. Hopefully, it's all right. We'll have to wait and see. We'll find out together. I'll hit you guys up on Twitter. Follow me at Matthew Petey. Once I know, you guys will be in the know too. Now the defense. No. You're not off my shit list. All right, you did not escape today because once again, you got worked. And you can draw it up to a multitude of reasons, but there's really only one big reason. You let Kyler Murray bully you. Plain and simple. Here's the stats from the Cardinals offense today that had no problem. At times, maybe in the second half, but honestly, the Cardinals kind of took their foot off the gas a little bit. The first half, they moved up and down the field at ease and just wide open, like DeAndre Hopkins, completely blown coverage. He could have sat down in a fold-up chair and had a hot dog in the back of the end zone before anyone would have come close to him. He could have finished the entire Lord of the Rings trilogy at that point. That's how open he was. So shout out to the Cardinals offense, because one quick side note here, maybe Arizona is way better than we thought. Producer Jack from Arizona, I think we are not giving this Cardinals team enough credit, and they deserve a lot of credit because they're the last standing team. They're the last undefeated team. Wrap up the show. Give your record prediction. Let's get your updated record projection. Browns are 3-3 now. Where are you thinking now? Because originally, starting this season, I had them as a 12-4 team. Now I'm at least at 11-5, maybe 10-6. Sorry, that's where I'm at right now. You're 3-3, and you're a third of the way into the season. Someone do the math for me. Yeah, third of the way into the season, 17 weeks, 6 games. Even more than that. All right, just give me your record prediction down below. I'm going to try and cool off because today really sucked. You guys know it too. Sound off in the comment section.